Hey, welcome to the show. Today in the show, I have a challenging math problem for you. It is the order of operation. This is a tricky one. Right now, if you want to go ahead and pause the video, and when you're ready to check it with me, hit the play button. All right, let's go ahead and begin. First of all, when you do order of operation, remember you always do what's inside parentheses first, then your exponents, then multiplication and division from left to right, and addition and subtraction from left to right. All right, so take a look at this. How would you say that? Is that 2 divided by 1 or 1 divided by 2? That is 1 divided by 2. Remember, that's like one apple, and now you'd have to give that to 2 people. So I need to do a little division to figure this out. And so I put 1 right here and my 2 right here. Okay. Can I put 2 into 1? No, you can't. So you need to add a decimal point. So when I put a decimal point here, I need to put it up here. And then I can put my 0. Now can I put 2 into 10? You can, can't you? 5 times. So I put 5 right here. So 5 times 2 would be 10. All right, which would give me 0. So the answer right here would be 0.5. Now I'm going to go ahead and erase that, but that's how you would find the answer. Get my eraser here. So now this would be 0.5. Let's bring that 0.5 down here. Put my parentheses right here and the 2. And then I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this one. And I might as well just go ahead and do this exponent right now. 3 to the third power. Do you remember how to do that? 3 times 3 times 3. So 3 times 3 would equal 9, and 9 times 3 equals 27. So we have 27 over 3. All right, so 27 divided by 3. Let's go ahead and remember, we're working from left to right. So there's so many things. Now, remember, if you wanted to do that step later on, that's okay. So now I have 2 times 0.5. This means multiplication. So you can take 0.5 right here times 2. All right. Now, remember, when you're multiplying with a decimal, don't worry about it. You do the decimal later on. You're just counting how many numbers are behind the decimal point. And I only have 1. So right away, first of all, what is 5 times 2? 10. And you're going to put the decimal point right here. Okay, it's because I have 1 number behind there. So that should match up right there. So my answer is 1.0. Now, 1.0 is the same as saying 1. So we just have 1, all right, right here. Now, if you're saying, I'm not sure if I understand that, we have 2 times 0.5, all right? So that would mean I have 2, I don't know if you can see that with the light here, I have 2 half apples, all right? So if I have a half an apple, and then I have another half an apple, and it's squish it back together with some super glue. Now you got 1 apple. So now let's go ahead and keep on. So we have 27 over 3. All right. So this you would use division. All right. So it's like 27 divided by 3. Here's 27 divided by 3, which is 9. So we have 9 right there. So we have 1 plus 9. Can you do this one? I bet you can. If you've done all of this, I think this one will be easy cheesy for you to do. 10 right there. How'd you do? I would love to hear from your comments down below. It's fun, isn't it? It should be fun. There's lots of different ways you can achieve the answer. Remember, math is like a puzzle. Make it fun. And I hope you're having a fun day out there too. Hey, I'd sure appreciate it. Hit that subscribe button, hit the likey button, hit my other, I got some other YouTube channels out there. Check them out. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Adios.